I want to do another project with the kingfisher. So I'm in a nature reserve alongside a river. It's a side river, a branch of the River Rhine, which is largely fed by rain water and water from the Alps when the snow melts. So there hasn't been a whole lot of rain lately. So that means the level in the river is really low, and that also gives me possibilities to set something up for the kingfisher. Just in case, I brought my A7R4 with the 200 to 600 millimeter as well. In case we bump into something nice. What kingfishers need to get their food is like overhanging branches over the water where they can sit on, look into the water for their prey. That is not possible right now. Now my idea is to offer them a really nice branch overhanging over the water. And what I would like to do is do that on such a location that it will be possible for me to put up my tent, my hide. So I need a location which would be offer deep water for the kingfisher, where they can dive, preferably at a location where the kingfisher would not be in bright sunlight like today. It would be really nice to have a nice background. Well, there are quite a bit of possibilities here because it really looks natural. There's a really nice, curving water into the background. It would be really nice if I can find a place that would combine all that together. Oh, this might be perfect. As you see, the bank is quite steep, so that means the water is quite deep. There is already some overhanging branches. Can check for some sign if a kingfisher is already making use of that. If a kingfisher is already making use of that, it will be a matter of providing an even better fishing space for him. Well, there are enough branches over here from below that I can stick in, and here on the riverbank I can easily put my hide, so there's no problem. And the background is also really nice. Over there, it's quite far away. That might in the morning provide a nice dark background as well. So, actually, this looks about the only place a kingfisher is still able to fish from, so. There are tiny white droppings from a kingfisher. So I don't need to do any branches, sticking branches in at all. Because it's the perfect branch. It's hanging over the water. Kingfisher is already making use of it. Nature provides everything already. Then I just need to return when I have the chance. And hopefully, kingfisher will show up then. Perfect. I'm back today. I'm in my hide. I am a bit too low. I should be higher, but if I'm on the bank, I don't think that really would work out with the height either. So I have the camera quite high here in the height. And just going to see what happens. pretty awesome. So this nature reserve has, the water is connected to the river over there. But whenever there's a big ship going through it, the water level here will go up and down. So, and as I'm sitting on the river bank, my tent gets flooded a little. Pretty cool. Short moment, but I only made video. Sit down for a while and then up higher up between the branches, so I couldn't really make a clear photo or video. Then it took off again. I don't even know if it's the male or the female. I hope they will return. With its wings up, with the backlight right now, that's really amazing. So I set a much faster shutter speed right now. So I hope that next time when it comes up, it will sort of take the same route, and I will have a good photo of that. That also brings up an interesting topic, because as a vlogger, I also want to have some nice video of the bird, you know. So I heard the bird coming because I heard its call, so I set the camera on record so I would have a nice video of the bird landing. But in the end, it's about photography, so I have a nice video now, but no photo. Yeah, choices. I already told you that this river is being fed by rain. The river level really goes up and down, and I just noticed the water is really dropping. There's hardly any water under the branch at all. So, and when there's a ship, the water completely, it's being sucked away. So the kingfisher, that might be why the kingfisher was gone so quickly. Because the water level, it's dropping really hard. Because when I arrived here a bit ago, it was high enough, but now, sometimes below the branch, there's no water at all. And just when I said, now he sits over there. And he's up in that branch again. I made a few photos, but not when he arrives. He's at the same location, up in the branches again. And he's looking at the water right now. Let's see if I can make him. Video. I think he will look at that water right now and also see that there's no chance to do any hunting for fish over here because the water is just too shallow. And when there's no water, there will be no fish at all, so. Difficult times to be a kingfisher, I think. Not catching anything. Water is simply not deep enough for them over here. So what I will do now, I will just wait until it goes away so I won't disturb it. And then I will find a nice branch, put it there in the water so the bird can get used to the branch and can make use of the branch to get some food, because I think they will have a hard time finding food right now. And then maybe one of these days I will return. I have red feet now, but the kingfisher, when he returns, and the bobble. That's another bird. Oh, I was triggered by the sound. So, the kingfisher will probably return really soon. And then at least he will have a spot where he can properly fish from. And I'll just have to see if I can return in the next few days. It was great if I can help out wildlife in some way as well. Awesome. In the days after I returned a few times, I get under this branch. But it didn't really work out. The kingfishers really have quite a hard time right now. Because the water level just kept dropping. I was thinking the big tents. Yeah, I think for that location, it didn't really work out. It was a bit too large. So in the end, I used a camouflage net, and I put that over myself, and I really didn't like that solution either. I decided I needed another tent, and this time a tent where I could be low on the ground so I could lie in. I've researched for several options, and in the end I decided to go for the same brand that I already have a height from, the Butio Photo Gear. Yeah, you've seen the height. I've used it in this project, but I also used it, for example, on the Kingfisher project. If you haven't seen it, it's up in the card. So I literally unpacked that height from the box on the parking space over here. What I really think is important is that you can put up the height really quickly. I'm in the wild over here. I want to put up the height as quick as possible, get in, so I can blend in the environment again. So this height, I think, will meet that goal, but I have no idea yet, because I never put it up. So yesterday I returned to the area and saw a good fishing location, and I put up a new branch over the water. And actually I was walking away and I turned my head. The female was already on it. So let's see. The female was actually sitting on another branch in the middle of the water. But when she saw me, she flew to the branch that I put there. So I will just wait a little until she returns to a place that I won't disturb her. And then we will move the tent. It's warm in here. You can see the lens is fogging up. Well, that went pretty quick for the first time. Okay. It's cool, the male arrived. But he's sitting on the branch that isn't really... Well, it's nice, but it's not what I was hoping for, so... Let's hope he will move places a bit and give me a few opportunities on the other branches. It did got a few splashes into the water. I don't think it was hunting. I didn't really see it yet. I think it was more washing. And for a short while, one sat on the branch, which is really low above the water. But you can see the hectic nature of this project. But the background here and there is really busy. Yeah, there's a beaver here, there's lots of willow, and so there will be lots of branches, old branches which have been chewed on by beavers everywhere. There's not much I can do about it. Suddenly two yellow wagtails. Oh, that was beautiful. One was white in front of the hide. Oh. So right now, one of the two flew off a couple of hundred meters over there. There's a really high stick into the water. I think people placed that for the osprey. And one of the two kingfishers is sitting on top of there right now. I think from there they can have a look over the water and see fishes who are on the surface. To keep your house clean, right? Okay. Well, that was really nice day. Yeah, I really hope you liked this video. If you did, a like and a comment would be much appreciated. If you aren't subscribed already, please do so. And then we will see each other again in my next vlog. Oh.